Hello. I have graced you with my presence. ASMR. Got. So yeah, it's episode 4 of the Southampton Career Mode. So yeah, player of the episode, I don't remember much. Actually, no, I do. Last episode, I think it's gonna go to Tino Livramento, just because of his absolute class. Spread some love. I'm honestly just gonna put on the thief commentary. It's literally 7:30 in the morning. I don't really want to talk. I don't have the energy to talk. Got.
Hello, a warm welcome. We've dropped anchor here on the south.
I'm gonna turn it down a little bit. I put on 4.
Coast of England at St Mary's Stadium.
That's better. Oh, I forgot to change colours to left winger again. In Vega to a cam. This might be a tough match, you know.
And here's the starting 11 for Aston Villa. Albon Lafont is the goalkeeper. Diego Carlos plays alongside Tyrone Mings in central defence. And so many different ways to configure an attack. In this case, it'll be 2 men up front. And the danger is still there. So for Southampton, you have to say it was a great performance against Liverpool. What do you expect to see this time, Stuart?
Well, to go away from home and win is a good result for them in a really entertaining game. And when you look at the two teams today, I'd expect them to win again. They should be too strong for their opponents here.
Well, that's how to keep the opposition at bay. Quite a lot of discussion about him prior to this game, playing against his old club, and I wonder what's going through his mind, Stuart.
Oh, Derek, what a chance this is.
Safe pair of hands, did his job. Douglas Luiz. Now that pass easy on the eye. Oh, dealt with by the goalkeeper. Can someone get on the end of this? Well, they couldn't take advantage of the chance. Oh, beating his opponent with ease. And he takes it off.
Oh.
Now the keeper grabs it.
Got.
Cristiano Viraghi. It's with Anderson Tariska. And successfully cut out.
Thank you.
And they will be awarded a free kick for that. John McGinn. Ollie Watkins. Anderson Talisca. Surely. Oh, look at that. They've taken the lead. Well, we've seen the dominant team so far, but they're certainly not complaining about the scoreline. So underway again here. 1-0 the score.
Offside. He's freaking offside. He wasn't in line with him. Oh, what the frick ever. Honestly, this ref can go die. Go and kill yourself. Oh, you fat got Evan Nilsson. You're rubbish. For all of you, Drood. Oh, you think? Oh my god, get up! Free restarts every freaking season.
Hello and a warm welcome to the South Coast.
The power of freaking FIFA.
I'm Derek Ray in the commentary position.
Analysis
by Stuart Robson. I'm very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League.
Yeah, don't go back to it. Because you never do, do you?
Well, thanks, Derek. I certainly wasn't expecting Southampton to do quite so well in their opening fixture. They showed a lot of spirit, a lot of desire, and a fair bit of quality. They'll need to replicate that today, though.
Here's how the lineup looks for Aston Villa. Albon Lafont is the goalkeeper. Diego Carlos plays alongside Tyrone Mings in central defence. And so many different ways to configure an attack. In this case, it'll be two men up front.
Again, Rare! He's not even shoulder barging him.
That's a very fine piece of tackling. Coutinho. There's been a boatload of speculation surrounding him ahead of the game. Up against his old club, and that's never easy for a footballer. A mixture of...
Oh yeah, former club.
Well, I have to say, I never really played well.
Yeah, just
played.
Give the ball right to him.
I think he might find it difficult today.
Mohamed Kudus.
Oh. Yeah, referee, no, just no.
Really.
Oh yeah.
You have to say it was a good performance and result in the last match against Liverpool. How do you think this one will go, Stuart?
Frick off.
Win is a good result for them in a really entertaining game. And when you look at the two teams today, I'd expect them to win again. They should be too strong for their opponents here.
Oh well, it don't look like that to me.
And the cross into the middle.
Move! You stupid got. Oh yeah, well done, Cruz. Well! Honestly, I give up.
Going well.
Oh!
And he cuts inside.
Out.
Douglas Luiz. Gives it a go.
Oh, so you just stand there, Evan Nilsson. Yeah, Livermento, great player of the episode, you are. Lost the ball like three times this match in areas like that now. What are you doing? Can you, oh yeah, now you give it to him, don't you? My God.
Counter-attack is on, options available.
Yeah, I'm loving these runs being made. Finish. Oh, you gotta do it. You gotta do it. I just had to do it. Right in front of the home fans. And once he gets onto it, he just smashes it past the keeper with great technique. What an emphatic finish that is. And the ball moving again. What sort of response will we see from them now? Great tackle, Salisu. Okay, great tackle again. He'd been able to stay onside. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Stay onside, and that could have been a really big chance. Eva Nilsson. It's with Douglas Luiz. Musa. Nicely tight tackle. No advantage with them. Referee says play on. Honestly, I just give in. How is the pa- Freaking stupid. Go. Right, well, I've just got a new pad which is charged. Well, it's on one bar. I swear down, like 1 second ago, it just had 3 bars. Smash it as hard as possible. Yo, what do you mean by that? A level contest. 1-1. Oh, that's excellent. No referee. Eva Nilsson. Again, another brilliant play by the referee to, you know, be on there. See, oh, what? Like, he definitely isn't, like, right in front of you practically. How have you not got there? My God. I'm going to chop him in a minute. Right, frick off. Yeah, way. Half-time then, that brings the first half to a close here on the south coast. Suck your mum. Alright, freaking... That Evan Nilsson, frick off, he is rubbish. Actually, I think, just this game, I'm just going to do that. Actually, no, I'll do this. Because the play between these two is always good. I'd prefer Cudas at Cam than Silas, actually, because, I mean, Cudas just to run up and down and as the second half in the middle of the park, I mean. Sides can reflect on a first half in which they were so very evenly matched. And the advantage accrues to the attacking side. Their advantage? Isn't our player the one on the floor? Tremendous intuition to win it back. Right, a goal update to bring you from the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. That means we join... No one cares about Tottenham. Oh, Tyrone Buddy Mings with a 92 pace. Tyrone Mings has just caught to Cudas. And how much of a head start did Cudas have? A pretty good mood following this news. The contract situation ironed out. And he might be in action pretty soon, Stuart. Well, I think he'll fit in well to their style of play. Do I care about Arsenal?
just bring out the best of him. It's a good sign.
At this moment, why should I care about Arsenal?
Well, no danger now.
Why should I give a damn about who Arsenal have signed?
It needs an accurate cross.
Oh, what? You thought I was crossing it? More chance.
Well, that took a deflection.
That wasn't even 2-11, man. Oh, by the way. So, I mean, that's just FIFA being FIFA again.
Douglas Luiz. And whipped into the
what is that?
Goalkeeper's ball. Disappointingly for them.
Oh, you think? Oh, my days. Oh, get up now. Get up.
I'm showing excellent vision.
Yes, the ref, if it was their player, you'd stop, wouldn't you? If it was their player, you'd stop, wouldn't you? Kid hell.
Douglas Luiz. Well, they know they need to stop him.
Well, the stats confirm it. Southampton have had the lion's share of possession, but it's been a frustrating performance from them so far. They just haven't had enough guile in the final third. It's all been a bit too predictable, which has to change.
Oh my God! Can you not scroll down for once?
Perfectly positioned to take it away.
I'm sick of this game. I'm done with it.
Take the lead here. Oh, he's been denied. And they remain locked together.
Well, that's a good save, but really he should have scored from there. That's a big chance.
Oh, short corner. Let Marsh shock her. Big surprise, isn't it? Because that's all he can bloody do. Because they don't have the audacity to a normal corner like a normal person. I mean, I got so much with my corner technique. I boot the ball like, all the way back, but still. No! Oh, you think? Didn't just boot it to the corner flag, did he? What are you doing? Freaking hell!
It certainly wasn't a clean tackle, and the referee has got to book him, I think.
Right.
Silas?
I was gonna say, if he don't get booked for that. Oh!
It's still alive!
Who's this man?
Threatening, but the danger averted.
Oh my days. Great tackle. No then.
Coutinho makes his way.
Frick off. Great tackle.
And after that fantastic effort, it's gone out for a throw-in.
I've got a red for you. Gas, gas, gas. I've got to do player of the half, by the way, but... oh my God.
The game, it might be decisive. And just look at their supporters.
Yeah, right.
Well, a dramatic moment near the end.
Loving that goalkeeping.
Now we're inside the final 10 minutes.
Oh yeah. You do brilliant. Oh. Why do they keep pausing? Oh, because I'm pausing it.
Watkins. Excellent ball over the top. Well, not to be.
Oh, really?
Right that he wants to run in behind, but he has foul. To get the timing right.
Douglas Luiz. Trailing as they are, they're not likely to get too many opportunities late in this game.
Oh, you think again? Oh, here we go. Zero defenders. Oh, I mean, that's both the bloody corner flag, doesn't it?
Well, they'll be looking to add to their advantage from this corner. And a bit short with the clearance.
My God. Right to them, obviously. Yeah, right to them again. Come on, get forward. Oh, we could have gone closer. God's sake. Oh, keep us up.
Body in the way. Great block again.
Get it, get it, get it! Oh my! Days, another restart. One bloody match.
Hello, a warm welcome. We've dropped anchor here on the south coast of England at St Mary's Stadium. My name is
God. Evan Nilsson was a waste of money. He was wet. We were so much better with Salah. Right, it's Southampton. Up against Aston Villa. But yeah, we really do need to put Vega at Cameron Cuddison wing. Game.
They showed a lot of spirit, a lot of desire, and a fair bit of quality. They'll need to replicate that today, though.
Evan Nilsson.
Okay.
Here's how the lineup looks for Aston Villa. Albon Lafont is the goalkeeper.
Albon Lafont.
Alongside Tyrone Mings in central defence. And the story in attack.
Oh yeah,
Lafont. Strike partnership.
Oh, that would have been a good keeper sign for us. Instead of stupid Ramsdale.
So you have to say it was a great performance against Liverpool. What do you expect to see this time, Stuart?
Well, that win in a hostile atmosphere.
Hello! Oh my God! What a shocker! Hello!
Buendia, big chance! Oh, good work by the keeper!
Oh, look at you! It's all you can do!
They favoured a short one here.
My days! Yeah, because it's what they do every time. My God, so you head it that way.
Coutinho's corner.
Yeah, frick off. Nothing. Like,
Ollie Watkins. Well, that's how to keep the opposition at bay.
What a ball. Then freaking Donker.
Into the advanced position. He's played it over to the near post. Cleared away.
Why give it to... Okay.
Musa.
Musa.
Crossing possibilities. And he takes on the shot. And that's fine goalkeeping. Real concentration.
Hit the ref, please.
Kudus. That's not a bad
no balls, oh, my God, what a shocker. Strong play. Oh yeah, so you go on the ground, don't you? Big surprise there.
Well, he's featured on the back pages of quite a few newspapers in recent days.
Great tackle.
His old club, and that can bring with it a few complications.
Oh yeah.
Well, for some reason, playing against your old club can be difficult. You just feel that bit of added pressure. I hope it doesn't affect him today.
Still alive. Good.
I don't even know what Ramsdale's doing. Oh my days. Just whatever. Oh yeah, you think.
The ball is moving once more. How important will that opening goal prove to be?
Very important, is it? I've been in the last freaking three matches. I've freaking played in this one stupid match.
Will it be sufficiently imaginative? Anderson Taliska.
God.
Oh, a lovely ball.
Oh, you've saved something. I'm shell-shocked. Let me get a short corner. Oh, I'm shocked.
Who can he pick out?
Right to him! Oh, Ramsdale has to make a big fuss out of it. Although it definitely wasn't right towards him. Oh, that's class.
And room now out on the wing.
Okay.
And the defender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. And played short. Douglas Luiz and a fine cross.
Why am I even crossing it?
Mohamed Kudus. Is it going to be?
No, it was
begging to be put home, but the goalkeeper has.
Oh, was it? No, but it was bound to be shot right at the keeper. Oh yeah, and you go to the ground again. Big surprise.
It's been a really good performance from him so far.
Oh, the crossbar is still reverberating. Well, able to survive that.
Oh my days! Yes!
Buendia. Oh, fancy footwork. And that's going to be the goal.
Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm sure most of you guys saw that clear run being made by Vega on the left. No, he has to boot it towards the keeper though.
And I must say that was a very promising attack. The alarm bells were sounding.
They're not sounding no more.
Well, the counter chance looks
very ooh,
real.
Will we score?
And the cross
oh my! Well, Moussa, you are being sold.
John McGinn.
I'm never using you in another career mod ever again. Same with Evan Nilsson.
1 minute of stoppage time has been added on. Chances on. Terrific.
Same. Same with Evan Nilsson, like I said.
He read it so well.
Oh my god.
Well, just listen to the fans. They know this is a big chance here.
And they're going for the short one.
Oh my days! Swear down if the stupid pad turns off one more time.
Well, Anderson Talisca was influential.
Honestly,
in the first
give up with this game.
What did you make of his contribution?
Well, I thought he had a really effect.
Oh, you think? We had the ball for freaking like half, like 3/4 of the freaking half. Okay, I don't know why it just.
Well, underway once more, and it's going to be fascinating to see what developments occur in the second half.
Them probably getting another goal and winning the game. To be fair, we are a team who's just come back from the championship, and we barely won the championship.
Excellent vision.
So I can't really expect much, although we literally beat the best team in the Premier League. Oh, finish! But we beat the best. Well, to be fair, we went 1-0 down to the best team in the Premier League, and then I simmed the rest of the game. And we won 3-2. Oh no, actually we were 2-1 down. We were 2-1 down. And then we won 3-2.
Right, a goal update to bring you from the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. That means we join Alex.
It's a lot better play from us.
Well, space for them here. Douglas Luiz.
Right, okay.
Keep possession.
Mm-hmm.
It's there for him. Well, the challenge was.
Now we don't need the ref. We don't freaking need the ref. We do not need the ref.
No wonder they're celebrating. So the ball is rolling again.
Mill.
2-1 the score. What's going to happen next?
God, how the tables have turned. What did I say to the players at half time?
Watkins. Beautifully weighted ball.
Get out, get out, get out, please, just get the ball out.
Still a chance.
Thank you. Oh, we won a header.
Well, that was a great save. But the way they're playing at the moment, the equaliser can't be far away now.
Well, unlucky perhaps to be denied, but they've now got to think about defending. Is it going to be?
Oh, 5 hours later, you might take the shot, maybe. Just maybe. Can you win it? No, you can't. Heck, no, you freaking can't.
We wondered if this deal was going to be done. In fact, it has now been done, Stuart.
Unai Nunes. Darwin Nunes, brother. Imagine who actually is, though.
Well, not every keeper would have been that brave.
Well, he read it brilliantly, didn't he? Top stuff from the keeper.
Eva Nilsson. Yunus Musa. Dangerous looking attack.
Oh my days. Tyrone Mings. Oh yeah, that's a play on, isn't it?
Douglas Luiz.
Oh my days, Evan Nilsson, you are a waste. If I could sell you, I would. I bloody would. But you're lucky I can't, and I don't have any money to replace you. Go on.
Now can they counter clinically?
Oh, you stop your run, don't you? What a ball, though. Fair enough to Musa. That was a great ball.
A quarter of an hour remaining here. McGinn.
Great tackle.
Another corner here.
Okay.
That might boost their hopes. And there's the delivery. Well cleared away.
Go to the wing. Great ball.
From one side of the pitch to the other. And options in the centre. Big chance. Goalkeeper
can't. Freaking Lafont, man. You cover up the whole freaking net. I'm not trying to say fat, but like still.
Probably would be the end of the story. Yunus Musa.
Ooh, almost went. What? He had to die for it.
Well, there's still scope for late drama here. 5 minutes left, and just one goal between the sides. Musa. I must say, this looks promising. Eva Nilsson.
Oh my days.
Douglas Luiz. And a goal! They lead by two now. And that allows them to breathe a bit more easily.
Just look how well balanced he is. He knows he's going to be under pressure, but he shows great composure to hit the target.
So back underway at 3-1. Chambers. And we are going to have 2 additional minutes. McGinn. A foul, but advantage played. Anderson Talisca could pull one back here. Terrific save. And fed in by Coutinho. And there we have it. The referee brings this match to an end. And maximum... Big chance. Oh, good work by the keeper.
Still can't believe this.
Still alive.
Oh, Ramsdale, what are you doing? I made some really good saves in that game. And he made a big save here. Man of the match has to be one of our players. Cruz.
No. friend showed me this video where this guy orders a pizza, and then when the pizza woman comes over to give him the pizza, she starts messing with him. Like, she takes off her shirt and she has to take off her shirt and start like doing nasty.
Who showed you that?
My friend Kevin.
Okay, I don't.
You know how mad that would make me? I'd call that pizza place up. Like, hello?
Yes, I ordered a pepperoni pizza for my family to have a lovely evening, and then Emily came over and sucked my dick.
My friend showed me this video where this guy.
Yep, go ahead and sleep all day. I'll do everything myself.
Oh, okay.
The one that don't use sunscreen. The one that's swept underwater. The one that brought too much stuff. The skinny one. The skinny one. The one that writes crush's name in the sand. The shells collector. The runner. The one that don't want to go home. The one that don't.
Mommy, can I use the toilet, please?
Not yet. You gotta finish our alphabet first.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, O, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z.
Where's the B?
It's halfway down my leg, Mom.
Hey, babe, have you ever heard of the ugly face?
Do you prefer these old or?
Mom?
Shut up, yeah. Hey, babe. Hey, babe.
I'm Derek Ray on the commentary gantry.
We're here live from the King Power Stadium.
I'm very much looking forward to bringing you action.
Oh, for God's sake. It's Larsson, the Swedish icon. That was excellent.
Well, the fans really want him to
that was. I give up on life. I give up. I speak too soon. And our team has just decided to culture attacking.
And a warm welcome.
Why not?
We're at the King Power Stadium in the East Midlands for this one. I'm your match commentator, Derek Ray.
This one's even worse than the last one. He's literally throwing on. Like, Coletta Carr is not catching up. Oh, he almost did. Oh, correct, sir. He almost did catch up to him. I don't like free kicks, man. There's no I can do from it.
And he takes it on.
The what? Where? Did their player just save it? What is that? Excuse me? Ball-like? What the hell? What is this? That was going in as well. That is the weirdest glitch I've seen yet on FIFA. What? And now the play? That's not fair, man.
Playing it short. Douglas Luiz. Well, a shot from miles out.
What the hell?
Into the final 20 minutes. Alex Blanco.
Alright, wait. If we lose this, this is not fair.
And that is that.
Alright, no. We need to restart that. Because you already know that was not fair. We would have scored that free kick. We probably would have scored that one after where the player saved it from the corner.
This is the scene here at the King Power Stadium.
That is the weirdest thing that I have seen yet. Is that Larson again? Ever. Why is their keeper outfield?
Back with McTominay. And a crucial intervention inside the box.
What is this game? The player's gonna save it again. What is this?
And space to cross it. Gnabry. He must finish. Well kept out.
Let me guess, that player's probably going to save it again. He's right footed, isn't he? Yeah. Zoom.
Understandably, he wanted to give it a go.
Oh. Well, the player isn't in that.
Can he make it 1-0?
Zoom.
And the spot kick is converted as and the final whistle is sounded.
Alright, thank you. That is the weirdest thing I've seen on FIFA of all time. By all time. I've just been in this FIFA all time. That is the weirdest glitch. I just realised we went up with Fulham and Blackburn came up with us, so Swansea didn't get promoted. Cristiano Ronaldo is still playing. Ah. About Mercedes-Benz. How is he still worth that much? 43 million. Who is he? It might not work. This is literally the GOAT idea. This is being bad for us. Then just get rid of him. Probably could have got a lot less of that.
Because he's been, is he not playing good? And we're going to literally get a higher rated striker. So be it. I don't care how old they are, how much they drop. He's experienced, he's won the Champions League. Played in the big leagues. I think, by the way, this career mode will probably finish by the end of this season. This career mode won't remain for much longer. As I have another one in mind for us to do, which I've always wanted to do. And I keep forgetting. I was supposed to do it before this career mode, but I forgot. So I did a West Ham career mode instead because I forgot to do the career mode that I wanted to do. As I was saying before, my controller ran out. I need to get out of George quick before it runs out again. Yeah, so a Cardiff career mode I was gonna do, but I forgot. So I just thought, alright, since I forgot, I'm just going to go with a random career mode, I'll just do West Ham. And I got fired, so I ended up doing this career mode. By the way, do you want to know how well we did in that season where I got fired? We literally came, supposed to become. Oh yeah, we came 11th. Like, that isn't even that bad. And they fired me. I was going crazy. It's like, why, Daddy? Why did you have to fire me, Daddy? I mean, that Vida guy's here, but I mean, he literally dropped in an overall. Right, plays that I want to get rid. So that all these four rows are fine, like these four rows, but then it gets to here, like none of these players I am ever using. I know they're young chance, like Edozi or whatever his name is, Simeu, Small, Lario, Watts, Lundalu, Oliver. Legb. They're all good talents for the future, but I mean, when am I ever going to use them? In the space of one more season. Leeds are. I'm going to trust the lads for that one. Hopefully Lewa can get a debut goal and a debut win. Most importantly.
Mom, why is the Christmas tree moving? Number 4, Chrome Punk. If you completed all the quests, this is the closest you'll get to blending into the Chrome for free. Number 3, Ruby Shadows. This version of Ruby was free to own for a limited time. If you liked a clean, sweaty skin to help you look like a pro, then this is the one. Number 2, Major Man Cake. Might not seem free to win, but if you kill the NPC at Rocky Reels, you can take his place and wait for unsuspecting players. Number 1, the default skin. The first skin you'll be able to use is also its most free-to-win skin. Make him think you're an absolute noob, then strike. Top 5 free-to-win skins. If you have more than 3 of these in your locker, then we can't blame you for cheesing it every now and then. You can stop a bullet.
Explosions do not wrap up walls. We have won all of our games. Leeds have only won one and lost two. Lost two. They've either drawn all 3 of them or won one and lost two. I doubt they've drawn all 3 of them. Yeah. Lewa gets a debut win and a debut goal. That's brilliant. Douglas Luiz and Matazzo. Both our CDMs pick up a goal. A bit odd.
You can open the back of a cargo ball. You can shoot while falling.
That doesn't make any sense.
Can you flip a ramp car?
Wait, what?
Apparently you can spray poop.
It confirmed.
Walking into a power box electrocutes you. Glass panels deflect tank shells.
to me.
Off shallow water.
What?
You can steal vehicles faster if you shoot the window. Wow, I instantly opened the door. You can stop your car immediately if you press OF4.
Actually, stop.
Wearing a helmet will stop headshots. Can rockets go through a car's...
Oh, wow, it actually worked.
Can rockets go through a car's broken window? You can open the back of a...
Excuse me? I have a quick question. I'm a videographer, and I wanted to film you a quick car video.
Yeah, I have like a car meet next week if you want to do it then.
No, I won't take too much of your time.
Okay, better not.
What type of car does a guy need to drive to get your attention?
A Honda Civic.
Sometimes you get a very good number.
Arsenal are only on 3 points. They have only won one or drawn three. But yeah, I will accept a loss because we lost to them when we were in the championship and we beat them. A rebound gets them done. A Lewa. Lewa once, Lewa twice. Then a rebound saving us inside the last couple of minutes.
Does a guy need to drive to get your attention?
A Honda Civic.
Sometimes you get a
have 6 players to choose from at their peak. LeBron, MJ, Steph, Kobe, KD, and Shaq. Who gets pushed to the bench?
This KD.
Might be the hardest NBA question I've seen. Is definitely not an exaggeration, Uncle Drew. At the one, I'm starting Steph Curry. He's a generational talent that changed the way basketball is played. I believe this would transcend...
I don't know Shaq, because he can't score a free. He only scored 1 3 in his whole NBA career.
The GOAT, Michael Jordan. Not only is he Air Jordan, but he's master of the fadeaway jumper and can put the clamps on any other guard ever. At the 3, I'm going with the GOAT, LeBron James. He's arguably the most naturally gifted athlete ever, and he could start on this team for 20 years and not lose a step. At the 4, I'm going with Kevin Durant. He can stretch the floor, post up, and fade away, guard perimeter players, and block shots. At the 5, I'm going with Shaq. He's the most dominant player ever. No one in any era can stop him down low. And that means Kobe comes off the bench. When you base your game around the master, you can't start over the master, in my opinion. What would you change? Let me know in the comments.
How could you start Kobe on the bench?
You have 6 players to choose from at their peak. LeBron, MJ, Steph.
LeBron, MJ, Steph, Kobe. MJ being the GOAT. KD and Shaq. Shaq on the bench because he can't score a three. I know he's dominant, but so is MJ. It's between KD and Shaq. You can't put Steph on the bench. He's the most gifted, basketball player ever. And then LeBron for his athleticism, Michael Jordan just because of his mentality. Kobe because of his, like, he's just powerful. KD can't, I guess, like, I don't know, I guess like jump shots. Oh.
Push to the bench. This might be the hardest NBA question I've seen. Is definitely not an exaggeration, Uncle Drew. At the one, I'm starting Steph Curry. He's a generational
talent.
Hello,
warm welcome. We've dropped anchor here on the south coast of England at St. Mary's Stadium. I'm Derek Ray.
Shaq just can't score a three. He's the most dominant player out of all of them 6 players. But he can't score a three. Wait, why am I playing this match? It's the Carabao Cup. Oh no, I don't care. I mean, we won, but still. I love how Liverpool can only beat Chan Mae Rovers 2-0. You know what would make FIFA so much better? If the National League was in it. You know, I doubt they're going to focus on the National League, like the ratings and all that. Like, it'd just be too difficult. Full, again, either 3 draws or just 1 win. beat Arsenal. We can beat Fulham. Lewandowski kind of slowing down on the goals a little bit. Can't be having that. You can't be an Olivier Giroud. Jup. Country road, take me home. Alright, they've had one draw. They're probably rock bottom. I mean, I'm not surprised. They have Harry Potter left wing. And they have Oxlade, just okay. Hickey, Klosterman. They've got some decent players, but the rest of the team's just crap. Come on, we've just lost to a team with Harry Potter. Oh, he's probably put a spell on the players or something. Like Leviosa or something.
Without getting him any, let's see what happens.
Yo, Nick.
Yo.
Is there an Oreo cake?
Yeah, dude.
My favorite.
I know. You want a bite?
I'm good.
What? Why?
I have my own Oreo cake.
Oh, what?
It smells funky, though.
What's it smell like?
Kevin, are you serious right now?
Messi has spoken about his retirement. At you, idiot. Right now, bro.
Are you serious right now, bro? Give up.
Number 8, Paul Atreides and Chetty. Their destiny awaits. Number 7, Beast Boy and Raven. They're looking.
Knock off brands. Instead of Dove, we got the classic Dave. We all love McDonald's, but what about hot dog? Not a chance. Surely this is Nutella, nothing crazy. Nut mess. Lay's best chips on the planet, but here we go, Lay. Nothing beats a Sprite, just a classic soda, but here we got Sprite. Oh, some new sandals. Hopefully they're Adidas. A Beebus. Five Guys Burgers.
Oh no, I'm not playing Five Bucks.
Two Guys Burgers.
We can lose all we want. I'm not playing. I'm sick of betting. We can lose, that's fine. I don't care. I'm not playing Five Bucks.
Instead of Dove, we got the classic Dave.
I got you. Let's ask an AI image generator to show us.
And they all fell to their knees and begged that drip to beg them please as he raised his fist for his foot. I am the righteous hand of God, and I am the devil that I use for God. And I told you one day you will see that I'll be back, I guarantee. And that hell's coming, hell's coming, hell, hell's coming.
Got you.
That could one day save your life. If a tornado looks like it's not moving, that means it's heading towards you. If you ever see square waves in the water, get out immediately. These waves have powerful currents under the water that can sweep you out and take you away. If someone falls into cold water or is close to hypothermia, don't put them next to a fire. They need to be warmed up slowly, otherwise it could be potentially fatal and they could experience something called afterdrop. And this is due to the fact that your blood flow cannot adapt quick enough to...
Drugs. I'm already high enough. Ah, you got me good. Ah, I'm already high enough. I only got it.
Play Fortnite with the boys, so please don't call me, please don't text me, please don't come downstairs, and please let me play in peace.
Okay, have fun.
Yes.
Oh no,
I'm done eating.
Hey honey,
can anyone tell me why humans have different blood groups?
This has been debated over time. The amount of money that women are getting paid in the WNBA, and it's just not fair. I mean, there's not really a comparison here. The veteran minimum in the NBA is something like $1.3 million, and the top paid player in the WNBA is about $230,000. Now, ESPN posted a podcast clip featuring Kelsey Plum, one of the players in the WNBA. So let's listen to what Kelsey Plum has to say.
You're not asking to get paid what the men get paid. We're asking to get paid the same percentage of revenue shared. Like, for example, they sell my jersey in Mandalay Bay, I don't get a dime.
You don't get any money from jersey sales?
That's crazy.
And I actually commented this on the post, and I will admit it was kind of botched.
I love how it's always cold on a school day, but then, like, when it's not a school day, like, because on school days, we weren't allowed to go out, so it's all pitch was icy. And now we're not at school, it isn't, like, cold at all. And nothing's icy. Oh, get in. Alright, that was better late. Finally, scored. It was raining a bit this morning at like 6. It was raining all night, actually, to be fair. I'm already high enough.
Hi.
Lost in the way you move, the way you feel. One kiss is all it takes to fall in love with me. Bye bye. Italia. Ah, John Stone. Bep, bep, bep.
Harry Maguire.
I'm
not taking anything away from him because we're going to be able to touch over 12 feet at 5'10 is amazing. But I touched over 13 feet and I am only 5'7". And not only touched 13 feet, but I grabbed that cup from the top of the backboard, which is 13 feet. I never get recognition for the amazing things I do, but everyone else does. I'm not taking anything away from him because for him to be able to touch over 12 feet at 5'10 is amazing. But I touched over 13 feet and I am only 5'7". And not only...
Oh, West Ham are doing really well as well. Yeah, this is again that we're playing. And they don't have a 5-pack, do they? So all the games we'll be simming this season that are like good teams that we would verse are Wolves, Chelsea and Spurs because they have 5-packs. Wait, did I say Spurs? Oh, yeah, Spurs. Is it? Wolves, Chelsea, and somebody else. This is my kingdom come. This is my kingdom
come. What the grade you're going to this year says about you, part one. Comment what grade you're going to right now, because some of y'all started summer school and I feel bad.
Let's go.
All right, now anybody going to 11th grade is going to the hardest year of their life. 11th grade year is so trash, but if you're not taking chemistry, you're not taking physics, it might be good. All right, now we have the people going to 5th grade. You are so young, and that's a compliment. If you tell youngins they're young, they get so mad.
Enjoy it. All
right, now we have the people going to 7th grade. I ain't gonna lie, 7th grade was probably one of the best years of my life. 7th grade is just fun. It's like you have...
What do you mean by that? 7th grade is just fun. West Ham United. My first time actually using Lewa, my first time trying out Kudus on the wing in Vega at camp. So far it's been a good start of Vega, Kudus in their new positions. Oh.
Vega. On to Estupiñán.
My training, I wanna be in the number. That was excellent. Oh my, how has he got it in from there? Yo, what do you mean by that? How has he scored from there though? That angle. That is excellent defending from Livermento. I feel like Vega at Cam, it's going to be a whole different ball game now, you know. And with Kudus on the wing with his pace. I feel like Kudus won't get involved in the play as much as he used to. So I feel like Vega will be more involved in the match as Kudus. And Kudus will be less involved in the match as he used to be, but Vega will be more. And Vega will therefore get more goal contributions. And Kudus will start going down a little bit. But just with Kudus' pace and dribbling, I feel like he'll be more of an assist king on the wing. That's just what I think, though. I don't think he'll score much.
Would he play from the start? Would he be ready to play? Well, Stuart, we have our answer.
Oh, tactical foul. Oh. Scamacca, man, he ain't fast.
Well, I think you could call that an escape.
Oh.
It looked a certain goal.
Oh, my God.
It was a magical save, it was. Well, the referee let it go initially, but now he goes back and cautions him, Stuart.
Yeah, it's a good bit of refereeing. He tried to let the play continue, and then he came back for the booking.
Yunus Musa.
Ah, yeah, he ain't getting there. Oh, he actually got there as well.
Stop. The ball to the opposition
that time. Oh, what is that? Matazo's so bad now. Douglas, like, he used to be clear off Douglas Luiz, like, at the start of the season in the Championship. And then when he came back from his injury, it's like, oh. Again. Douglas Luiz just became so much better than Matazo, and now Matazo's just in his shadow.
And the short option preferred. And a good looking ball.
Ah, that's a good ball. See, this is what we can do. Come on, you got to be Pogba. You got to be Pogba, man. How?
I'm sure quite a few people were asking the question, what is the manager thinking about playing him in this position? But he has adjusted really well to it. Real chance. Still alive.
Yeah, I can see Vega's getting a lot more involved in the play than he used to. And he's creating attacks. But I feel like Kudus just the only problem at there. He won't get to show his absolute class, and he is like the only player with the absolute class to run through the whole team. Run through the whole opposition's team. But I feel like if we use him correctly, and he tries to get involved in the play, and we do find him on that left side, then I think he will be quite good in that position.
Nice looking pass.
What a ball.
Options in the centre.
Weak foot, okay.
And he dealt with that ball played.
Easy, easy, easy. My God.
Maxwell Cornet.
My God.
Space for them here on the flank.
Oh, that's in the team that who I'm literally supposed to be managing right now.
Taking one of those chances to get back into the game. Now will the cross work out for them? Oh, should have done so much better from there. He's going forward.
Come on, man! It's Kieran Trippier, for God's sake!
Now, counter-attacking possibilities here. Can they take advantage of the situation?
Yeah, this goal was literally zero defenders.
And he's done it.
Why is the game pausing, man? Freak off. Honestly.
So back underway. One goal apiece here.
Trip here, man. He's so annoying.
On the wing.
Oh my God, you're so bad.
Excellent header.
Excellent header. It's right at the keeper.
Well, attacking possibilities. Lewandowski. Can he finish?
Oh my God, you're so bad. I'm faster than you. I am literally faster than you. Slow down, I beat this Neek in a freaking rare.
And so that will be
player of the half. I'm going to go with one of their players because they've been very involved in the play. And it's their goal scorer, Scamacca. I feel like he's been really good. A close second would be Vega. Very, very close. Very almost first.
Oh, that's a really good run. Could be.
Oh, excellent. That was brilliant. Douglas Luiz, take a bow. To get the tackle and then to beat two of them on pace. But then this could have not been able to beat Trippier on pace, for God's sake. So, brilliant.
Lewandowski.
Okay, like that. Oh.
Can they hit on the break?
It's the number 9 curse. We've literally got the Chelsea curse. We've got the Chelsea curse. This curse of our strikers, we need to call it the Chelsea curse. I mean, except for Armstrong. Armstrong was really good. Armstrong has been a lowest rated striker that we've ever had in this Korean mode, but he was the best. Like Silas up front, Leo up front, Evan Nilsson up front, and Armstrong, 75 rated, was better than all of them. Taro Malaki has got a bit of pace, and I know that, so that's fair enough. Go on, Musa. It's all you, lad. All you. Oh. Why? Why does Leila actually have good corner stats?
Can someone get on the end of this?
Ooh.
And the goalkeeper's touch, that was crucial. And the referee has given the corner. So maybe scope here for them to add to their lead.
Oh, great ball.
Pressure high up the pitch. Opportunity to deliver the cross.
Oh, I thought Vega was going to win ahead of that for a sec. I was going to be like, no way.
Ah, well, fair enough. That's a good recovery. Well, we always enjoy
really lacking defensively, man. What is it? Come on, cut car. Tackle. Oh, Douglas Luiz, our saviour.
Plenty of support here. Lewandowski. Defensive resilience to shut them down. Now can they counter clinically? Oh, he's through here.
Well, great save.
And delivered.
My God.
And he's proved it yet again.
I'm just going to watch a defensive, for God's sake.
They've decided to make a change. A bit short with the clearance.
What? Great tackle. Ah, come on. Help him out. Help him out. We need players forward. Why does it have to be Leila? I mean, he's done well.
Must score. Able to close down the shot.
Pass back. Hello.
Vega. Kudus. Can he take the chance?
Ah, oh, I shouldn't have shot that.
In front of goal.
A cutback could have been the most sensible decision there.
Gianluca Scamacca. Space afforded him.
Oh.
And Paul Pogba waiting to fire.
Oh, well in.
And Southampton regaining possession.
Great ball.
Musa. Good looking sequence.
Oh. Oh my days. He's just turned him inside out. Oh, God. Right, player of the match. It's tough. I don't think Scamacca can get it. He did nothing in the second half. I mean, he did score another goal, but when we sim it, it doesn't count. So it's between Kudus, Salisu, and Vega. Nah, I'm just kidding. Aaron Ramsdale. Take a bow. I mean, how many times did he have to save us in that match? Honestly.
And so you're forced.
After this game, I'll quickly go on Fortnite to see if we're hands-on. No, this time, trust me, I don't have to go anywhere because my parents are at work and my granddad doesn't really go out. So it'll literally be a quick check if he's on live stream. actually not. I don't really like live streaming Fortnite.
So how many guns do you have per?
So if Ryan is on, then I probably won't live stream.
Very strict about it. We got like 0.3 guns per 100 people. That's barely any. That's pretty good. We got like 3 per 100 people. Oh, same as strict here. We got like 3 guns per 100 people. It's a pretty good ratio, although your population is huge, so you know the number's gonna be like big. Oh, we got 5 per 100 people. It's still strict here. Still a lot for your population, but good ratio though. Well, we got 12 guns per 100 people. Okay, yeah, you got them off. Yeah, makes sense. So we got like 23 guns per 100 people.
What a fabulous start to the season for him. Does he have more goals in his future?
Canada, aren't your people like nice and stuff? Why do they own so many? Oh, we don't use it for humans. We like hunt and stuff. Oh, okay, makes sense. We got 120. US, it's per 100 people.
Hello and welcome. Wherever you're watching, this is Goodison Park. Getting ready to bring you all the action, accompanied by my broadcasting partner, Stuart Robson. And we've got Premier League action coming right up. It's Everton.
Skills.
Well, thanks, Derek. The best coach I've played under would always tell us before kickoff, earn the right to play.
Earn the right to play.
Outrun your opponent, eventually you'll get the space to show your opponent. I'm sure that's being echoed by the coaches here today.
Well, that was a great tackle.
That challenge, you wouldn't be at all surprised if the referee reaches for his pocket. Well, there we have it. The first yellow card of the game.
Be careful now. There's a long time to go here.
A delivery towards the back post. Well, dealt with that ball comfortably.
Ooh.
That's a fairly easy save for any keeper to make. So for Southampton, you have to say it was a good performance and result in the last match against West Ham United. How might this one go, Stuart?
Well, in a very tight game, they certainly deserve their victory. Today, I'm expecting them to repeat that performance by having the majority of the ball and creating good chances. Let's hope we have some really good attacking football.
The supporters want to see him have a go.
Too many chances, so they need to make the most of this.
Keen to take it short here. Opportunity in the wide area. Well, decent effort, but not troubling the keeper too much. Boubacar Kamara. Well, defenders beware when Luka Jovic is on the pitch. Stuart, what do you think we might see from him in this match?
Well, how can you stop him?
Absolutely
if
nothing.
Get too tight, he'll use the space behind you, drop off, and he'll turn and run at you. Add that to his movement in the box, and you can see why he scored so many goals.
Pressing high, and they have the ball again. Full credit, wonderful stop. So the corner played into the box.
Oh.
Super header. It looked as though it might be going in. Failed to keep hold of it. In a position from which they could potentially do a bit of damage here. Quite possibly a yellow card as the clock was stopped. And following the infringement, a caution.
Yeah, no surprise there. That was always going to be a booking.
And fired from the flank into the area. So it's going to be a goal kick here. Just a quick reminder, we have more action from the Premier League coming your way.
I'm not playing against Coventry. We've got a five back. I'm sick of playing against five backs.
Lewandowski.
Oh my god. What is this defensive shape, man? Oh my. What is this? But I feel like they don't.
Well, here we can see it again. Look at the way he glides past the defender to create space for himself. And once he gets onto it, he just...
Look at the way fast he sucks his mum.
Great technique. What an emphatic finish that is.
My days, Vega. free call.
Nicely timed tackle.
Really struggling ever since Kudus has gone out on the wing. To be fair, I wouldn't call against West Ham, who's struggling actually.
Lewandowski. It's with Douglas Luiz.
Okay, Lee was standing there. Okay, right, great striker. That's what strikers are for, just to stand there.
Douglas Luiz.
Offside by a mile.
Well, it's not going to count. Flag up quickly then.
Yeah, he was offside by quite a bit there, and he knew it.
Going well. But nothing comes
of it. A frickle!
Well, Everton haven't bossed the possession, as you can see, but their counter-attacking has been really good, particularly in the wide areas.
Bro, they've had one attack. So far. We've had about 50, but Labour can't pass, so we can't get the ball inside of the box.
Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break.
Oh, yeah, right to him.
McNeil might be able to set up the chance. And you need your defender to take charge.
Drive, drive, drive. Oh, Moose.
Vega. Into the advanced.
Oh, is he heck? Oh, is he freaking heck?
It was anything but. Playing it in. No real challenge for the goalkeeper.
Shut up. God, if these commentators don't shut up, I'm going to freaking murder him.
Well, they have it again. Lewandowski.
Oh my days, he is rubbish. He suck my toe, honestly.
And Jovic now. This might be the perfect counter-attacking opportunity. But
great tackle. Getting Slissy's back pocket.
Showing one additional minute.
Oh my.
And so the first half story has been written. It's half time here at Goodison Park. Well, we can certainly say it was a fine first.
Alright, Leo, we'll frick off. Bringing our super subs. Actually, I think this would be better. Putting Cudders at cam just for the rest of this game. It's been working out this game. Everything's been brilliant. We've been by far the better team. Look at the stats. Just look at that possession. I mean, yeah, the shots might say otherwise, but we had way more attacks. But just needs to start getting the shots off. And if Ledward starts learning how to bloody pass correctly, then we'd probably be winning this game by now. But the defence has been brilliant. I mean, showing it once again. My God, why are you so bad?
Excellent defending.
Okay.
That's very effective. Good high pressing.
What is that? What was that?
To intercept.
Honestly, man, I give up.
Plenty of support here.
What the frick? What the frick?
You'll join us for more live Premier League action on EA TV. It's Southampton facing Manchester City.
No one in the box.
That's excellent defending.
Big surprise.
Cross.
God. Come on, man, Livermore. Freaking Dwight McNeil. You've done nothing this game. All of our good players have done nothing this game. Kudus have done nothing. I mean, I forgot he was on the pitch. Vega's done freaking nothing but lose the ball. Estupiñán has been the only really good player. Estupiñán has been best player on the pitch. My player of the half is Estupiñán. Well, as you can see, Southampton have had the majority. Even though we are losing. They need to pass it quicker, play forward earlier and show more energy. Oh. Otherwise.
They won't get back into this one. Substitution time it is here.
Let's just accept that we've lost this game. There's no getting back.
Kudus.
Swatch here.
Promising sequence.
Oh my. Oh my days! Who are you?
That's a brilliant save.
All right.
And a short corner, let's see. Cutting in, what can he do from this position? And a goal to level this
Well, that worked.
So in business once more, on the back of that very important equaliser, 1-1. Boubacar Camara. The referee knew that was foul play, but advantage it is.
Who the frick? Kamara's got a decent amount of pace.
Guehi? To the final 20 minutes. Well timed tackle.
Cross.
To take the lead.
Oh my god. Whoever the frick that is, Yerry Mina or freaking Ben Godfrey, whoever you are. I mean, you must have 95 pace, right?
Well, it petered out. And space to attack. Head over towards the back post. Well cleared away.
Won it. Thank you. Oh, get in! Get in! Well done, Vega. All Vega that. He got the first goal and he's got the crucial assist to put us back in the lead. Well, actually, to put us in the lead for the first time. Great tackle. By the way, I love how they I think they subbed Jovic off at half time. And I mean, look at the difference. As soon as they subbed Jovic off.
Well, this game ebbing away, and the visitor is on course to eke out a narrow victory. Stuart, your thoughts?
Well, it's been a decent performance from them. They've certainly played the more expansive football and had the better individuals. Can they now just see this through? Not long left.
Ducouré.
Douglas Luiz is the better DM.
Well, not troubling the goalkeeper at all there.
And from that sort of distance, you should be troubling the goalkeeper. Technique let him down there.
Douglas Luiz. Pervis Estupiñán. Moussa.
Ivre.
Wasteful from Southampton.
Great tackle. Well,
it was a foul, but good use of advantage by the referee. On the attack in the closing phase. But timely defending when it mattered. And that pass could be troublesome. And there it is, a chance. Can he finish?
What?
And the referee blows
up. Honestly, man. I mean, we're still one more, so. That was a great tackle. How did he miss that, though?
Another food.
Right, see, I'm just going to go see if, yeah, Silascott's the winner. I'm just going to go see if Ryan's on. If he is, then I won't be live streaming. If he isn't, then I might come back on. See ya.